Hey, Very Fish fans and fish tank ninjas. Hey, want to bring you a quick species highlight and tank. That's right, species highlight and tank. And I want to debunk some of the myths that you've heard about the Dichromis compressiceps, a.k.a. the Maliwali eyebiter.
Let's do it.
So this turned out to be a really nice show tank. It's got a group of eye biters, one male and approximately, I don't know, five or six females. All of them are about 6 to 7 inches big. I have some star sapphires. There's probably about four or five star sapphires. And I have a pair of yellow blaze Xerox. I also have a large Mpimbwe blue Frentosa male. Had to separate him out of my other breeding group. And I have a Splenodonis. He's swimming around in here somewhere. And typically, I don't have plastic stuff or shipwrecks, but a friend of mine gave me this beautiful extra large shipwreck, so I figured I'd kind of go for it. And it turned out to be really nice. The myth that these guys are going to, that the eye biters are going to run around and you're going to wind up with a bunch of dead fish or a pirate fish that's fish with one eye, that's just not true. Sure, when they breed, they get aggressive. They get aggressive typically towards the females. Haven't had any situation where they have killed anybody in the tank. So that myth is just a myth. So don't be afraid. Try these beautiful fish out if you ever got the opportunity. And I had them in this tank, and I actually watched them breed. And you're going to be able to check that out. So stay tuned later on in this video. But I'm going to give you a close-up of some of these just beautiful fish. Look at them. So these guys go crazy. Watch this when you feed them. There's about three or four star sapphires in here, like I said. The male. See if we can get him in there for you. Not bothering anybody, just a beautiful fish. Look at those star sapphires, fully flecked out. And back there, I don't know if I can see it, you can see him. You can see his reflection, big Mpimbwe blue. Everybody's flashing his color.
Called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamins? Yeah. You act like you ain't him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gon' pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy, you ain't even.
So I was able to strip the fry. There was probably about 35 fry in the female when I stripped her. They were free swimming fry, and I kept them in a breeder box for a while. And then I put them in my my grow out tanks. These are 20 longs. And what I typically do, like I've said, is I mix them to make sure that I can tell the specific species of the fish. For example, I'll only put one peacock in each tank of different species, because once you put small peacocks, you can't tell. Here you can really tell the distinctive color and shape of these fit of the fry. So here, let me show you. So hopefully you can see these guys. These little fry have they almost are starting to get the slanted characteristic front slope on their head, but more importantly, you can see the thin line going through their center of their body. And they're pretty quick, pretty fast swimmers, as you can tell. So I hope you like this Species Highlight and Tank. Remember, subscribe, ring the bell, put your comments down below. And next time I'm going to do a walkthrough of what's going on here, my refreshed 125. So thanks again.